St. Mary's story began 83 years ago in a rustic three-story older building in downtown Long Beach. With only 70 beds and a handful of doctors and nurses, a small group of Sisters of Charity of the Incarnate Word began the slow process of building a premier health facility. Today, more than 40 years later, the Sisters' small hospital has grown into a full-scale medical center, complete with ER, trauma, women's and children's health, radiology, cancer, cardiology, and rehab facilities. As the new 21st century progresses, St. Mary stands at the forefront of health care in Long Beach. The first superior of St. Mary's Hospital was Sister Mary Elizabeth O'Neill, who, with five other sisters of her order, came to Long Beach from Galveston, Texas, at the request of Reverend J.M. Hegarty, pastor of St. Anthony's Church. The original hospital was destroyed in the 1933 earthquake. Undeterred, the sisters conducted the first of many successful fundraising campaigns and broke ground on a new facility on 10th Street in 1936. The dedication in July 1937, attended by the mayor and the governor, began a new era for the sisters in Long Beach. Through World War II, the post-war boom in Southern California, and advances in medical technology, the sisters continued to expand their hospital, building the North Wing in 1949, the East Wing in 1962, and the Bower Tower in 1974. In the 1980s and 90s, dedicated to serving all the varied needs of its community, the sisters initiated a UCLA-affiliated medical education program, a low vision center, a hospice program, an AIDS outreach and education program, and a project to care for the increasing Southeast Asian community. In Long Beach, much of this occurred under the leadership of Sister Lucille Desmond, who retired from St. Mary in 1990. At the heart of all this expansion and community outreach have been the Sisters of Charity of the Incarnate Word, whose mission is to minister to all in need. For 83 years, they have been a stabilizing influence in Long Beach, and with the help of the doctors, nurses, and employees of St. Mary, will continue to give back to all those around them. From humble beginnings, the sisters have transformed St. Mary Medical Center into a premier healthcare center with a focus on excellence in treating all of a patient's needs, physical, mental, and spiritual. Today, the focus is no different from what it was 83 years ago. Yes, for 83 years, the Sisters of St. Mary have healed the sick, cared for the wounded and dying, and ministered to the needs of the sick at heart. They comfort the mother who has lost a son to a drive-by shooting. They hold the hand of the patient who dies alone. They rejoice with the child who can walk again after a long illness, and they pray with every patient who needs God's help. They make no distinction between rich and poor, black and white, young and old, nor do they question a person's religious preference or cultural or national origin. They minister day in and day out to the needs of the whole person, body, mind, and spirit. That's what makes St. Mary such a very special place. Tonight's Lifetime Achievement Award goes to all the Sisters of Charity who have spent their ministry at St. Mary. In your program are listed all the sisters who have served the Long Beach community at St. Mary. Pictured here are those who are still with us. If not here tonight, then with us at the Mother House in Houston. Sisters who have recently left St. Mary, such as Sister Edith Judge, who has shared her time between St. Bernardine Medical Center in San Bernardino and St. Mary. Sister Enda Marie McDermott, who came to Long Beach when St. Mary Hospital in Galveston, Texas, the cradle of the congregation, was sold. Sister Mary McCluskey, who served the pastoral care needs of St. Mary patients and families. Sister Pauline Gregorio, who was at St. Mary from 1990 through 2004, where she was an active member of the Foundation Board of Trustees and a St. Mary patient representative in the rehab department. Sister Gertrude Murphy, who for more than 20 years touched the people of Long Beach with her special kind of care. Sister Stephen Guiri, who served 2 years at St. Mary in radiology and information services. And then there are those we have lost. Sister Alphonsus, known to generations of Long Beach families and an icon of St. Mary. She was beloved among the staff, physicians, and people of this community for her constancy of commitment, her sense of humor, her passion for her patients, and her unbending demand that quality of care at St. Mary never be compromised. Sister Mary Sabina Sullivan, with her distinctive Irish brogue, who oversaw St. Mary's main reception desk and patient information services, and who, in the traditional habit of the order, was easily recognized on the streets of downtown Long Beach by her determined and rigorous stride. In addition to Sister Lucille, other administrators included Sister Mary Eusebius, Sister Wilfred Shorten, Sister Laura Murphy, Sister David O'Gorman, and Sister Mary Fenton. And of course, we celebrate those who serve at St. Mary now. Sister Gerard Earls, our Vice President for Mission Services. Sister Alice Buckley, our Foundation's Director of Stewardship. And Sister Kim Tran, our Associate Chaplain in Pastoral Care. And currently, service on the St. Mary Community Board. Sister Elizabeth Ann Hayes and Sister Kathleen Howard. Tonight, we pay tribute to our beloved Sisters of Charity for their lifetime of caring with St. Mary's Lifetime Achievement Award.